Here's another thing that Bill Gates will never experience again, because he's too wealthy, he's insulated. Six Fridays ago, when I tell you what happened, you'll be like, oh yeah, I'd commemorate that every Friday. I found a $20 bill in an old coat. A 20. Made my weekend. My plans changed. But what a feeling. Oh my gosh. Like I said, my plans changed. Now, not drastically. I still went to Chipotle Mexican Grill, which is my Friday night ritual. It's where I welcome the Sabbath. But here's how it changed. I brought my best friend, paid for him. Baller. And to answer your follow-up question, yeah, we both got guacamole. Unprecedented. Unprecedented. I never get the guacamole. I've ordered it, but then when she says, guacamole is $2 extra, I immediately start backtracking. I'm like, yeah, you're right. I was being impetuous. I don't know what I was thinking. I got caught up in the moment. There's no reason for me to get, not, no, I'll just, thank you. Thank you very much. You're absolutely right. Can we never mention this again? And then she says, mention what? And we share a laugh. There's also part of you that thinks, what am I wearing that she thinks I can't cover the guac? What kind of vibe am I giving off? Am I... She doesn't mean to be condescending, but isn't it implicitly condescending for somebody to look at you and decide that $2 might be a deal breaker? Guacamole is $2 extra. Do you want to call your bank, maybe? You want to check your balance because guacamole is $2 extra. By law, they have to, by Mexican food law, they have to tell you that guacamole is $2 extra. It's part of the Condiment Surcharge Disclosure Act of 2007. Where they have to tell you guacamole is $2 extra. And usually, I don't get it. But because I found a 20, she told me it was $2 extra, I didn't bat an eyelash. I had walked in there with such a vibe, like I was giving off like a confidence bordering on arrogance, like almost, not arrogant, but on the cusp of arrogance. And I looked at her, she says, it's $2 extra. I looked at her as if to say, yeah, why don't you let me worry about my finances? Why don't you just grab a melon baller and start scooping guacamole into a ridiculously small container? Why don't you let Gary Gulman worry about Gary Gulman? I'm Gary Gulman. Well, no, it's been a minute. It's been a few minutes since he introduced me. I thought I'd reacquaint you with our hero. So, so we're all on the same page. Bill Gates will never have that feeling. The found 20, it means nothing to him. Nothing. A 20 is more annoying to Bill Gates than a nickel is to us. Exponentially more annoying. And how annoying is a nickel to us? It is, I hate them. I hate them because they're quarter impersonators. They sit in your pocket and they do this, they do a great quarter. They're just like, you reach in there and you're like, oh, I got a nickel. Son of a bitch, nickel, you got me again. I gotta give it to you, do a great quarter. Do you do Christopher Walken? I won't charge you for that one. But you don't have change for the meter or for the laundry or for the Mike and Ikes at the front of the grocery store. You know what I'm talking about? The Mike and Ikes from the front of the grocery store? This is interesting. They sell candy at the front of the grocery store in gumball machines, okay? Those nasty, nasty gumball machines. They probably haven't rotated the stock in 35 years. They sell the same candy inside the grocery store in a box, hermetically sealed, free of all disease, fresher, and at a lower unit price than the candy at the front of the store. But schmuck that I am, if I have a quarter and they have candy out there, I'm like, no, forget about you, freshness. I want my Mike and Ikes to tumble down a spout, a disgusting, filthy spout that a dozen six-year-olds have shoved their measles-covered hands, their hepatitis C encrusted fingernails, trying to scrape free Mikes and or Ikes off the side. Yes, yes. If I'm gonna eat Mike and Ikes, I wanna eat my Mike and Ikes the same way a petting zoo llama would eat his Mike and Ikes. All right. Stay on point. Bill Gates, $20 means nothing to him. Because do you know what Bill Gates has to pull out of an old coat to feel like I did with a $20 bill? First of all, the idea that Bill Gates has an old coat is preposterous. This man doesn't have an old coat. If he has an old coat, it's the coat Abe Lincoln was shot in. And he wears it as a bathrobe. He wears it as a bathrobe. No underwear, by the way, no underwear. No, he lets his billionaire balls swing willy-nilly beneath the death cloak of the great emancipator. That's your 1%. That's your 1%. All right, this is what Bill Gates has to find in an old coat to feel like I did with a $20 bill. Here comes the ratio. All right, $20 is to my net worth. Let's use the median net worth for a man my age in this country, which is $100,000, and seems high. All right, $20 is to $100,000, as X is to 59 billion. Cross multiply and solve for X. He has to reach in and pull out, I kid you not, a $12 million bill. His 20 is 600,000 20s. You are not going to forget 600,000 20s in an old coat. Because as you lift it back into the closet using a forklift, you will think to yourself, hey, why does this weigh 1,320 pounds heavier, according to Ask.com, than it did when I put it on this morning?